Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we talked about some of the best practices of using Node.js, like if you are creating a simple microservice, what all basic features that microservice should have. Okay, so in this video we will try to baseline a simple microservice. We will be using Node.js and Express with TypeScript. Okay, you can either create the whole application from scratch, or you can just use Express CLI with TypeScript or Nest.js, which is already having support of TypeScript. Okay, so I will just create a prod folder here, which is, you say, a baseline. I will not use it. I will use it the already built my project, but I just wanted to show you what all things we are going to do in this. So first of all, we will start with a very basic, which is Express. Because with Node.js, we are going to install Express for our project. So first of all, we will just do npm init and initialize our package.json. Okay, so we got basic package.json here. And now we will install our first package, which is Express. When we do this, after this, we are able to start a basic server. Okay. This server will have a simple application, like you can actually create server.js. Okay, and this is having some basic definition about Express server. This is how we create a server. And in the package.json, you can start this server using, you can have a start command. And here I can say node server.js. Okay. So when you do npm run start, it will actually start this Express server on 8080 port. Okay. Now this is a very basic, you just run npm run, I think 8080 port is occupied. So I will just use 8089. And if I do npm run start, then it will start my application, right? This is very basic. This is how we start it. Now, we have already seen how to write a Node.js server, and if you are looking at this video, then you are already aware how to write Node.js application, because we are talking about Node.js microservices. So you are already aware how to write basic Node.js REST APIs using TypeORM, using SQLize, using Mongoose. Here we will talk about how we can add a TypeScript support for this application. So we will introduce TypeScript in our project. Okay. And we have to include tsconfig.json file, which is a TypeScript transpiler configuration. It is tsconfig.json. Okay, and I will populate it with a predefined configuration. Module is common.js and output directory is dist. Okay, and I'm looking for all the files which are in the SRC. Okay, so I will put my code in the SRC. And if we are using TypeScript, then we have to take care of the linting, all these different files. So we can include npm install minus minus c minus dev tslint. Now, why these need to be added in the dev dependencies? Because the testing library, the linting library, where you are checking the coverage, all these kind of dependencies are not required for your application at runtime. Okay, they are merely just for running the test cases or taking care of the linting, taking care of the compilations and all these things. So I will be adding tslint as a dev dependency, and I will create tslint.json. Okay, tslint.json, and here you can define all your tslint definitions. Okay, I'm just including only tslint recommended, but you can also extend it to any level. Okay, and I will update my scripts. Okay, in my package.json, this is my script, so I will just update it. This is my main index.js, and I will be writing server.ts file. Okay, npm run build will actually help me to build the code using TypeScript compiler. Okay, and before building the code, we will be doing a linting of our code and fixing it. Now, if you do npm run build here, okay, just convert this server.js to index.ts. And if you try to build it right away, and we will come to know. Missing script build, I think we haven't saved package.json. So we got one error, src, so our code should be in the src. Let's create a folder src and put index.ts inside src. All good, now we'll just run npm run build. Now you can see, these are the tslint errors, you can see. No variable initialization because we might be using some more keyword and all, okay, const keyword, and we are using require syntax. I mean, now we should be using the import export, right? Because now we are using TypeScript, so we should be just converting this into the ES6 mode of import export. So we have to write it using import express from express, okay. Rest, we are getting the express instance, and to support the TypeScript type definitions, we also need to add the type definitions for the Node.js and Express. So we have to add the type definitions for Node and Express from this command, types Node and types Express. So we don't see any compiler error whenever we are doing build. Now calls to console.log not allowed, obviously. So that is just a lint error. Now I think all good. We got dist folder, you can see. In the dist folder, we got index.js. So this is the compiled output we have received. So this is our final index.js. If you can also run this index.js file from the dist, or you can use a TS node or nodemon, which can also run TypeScript code directly without compiling it on the fly. Now if you do npm run start from the package.json, the start is doing node dot, right? So if I do npm run start, so it is doing pre-build, okay, and it is doing build, npm run build, and then we are doing node dot, right? So it is actually starting our server using this. So npm run start is doing pre-start, pre-start is doing pre-build. So it is like a, because these are the hooks, pre and post. So we did start, but it will do a pre-start first. Pre-start will invoke build. Build will invoke pre-build first. Okay. So chain of reaction is happening. And this is how our server is running. So now you can extend this example where you can include nodemon and all the other definitions. Like you can import tsnode and nodemon for this same project, tsnode and nodemon. Nodemon will help you to run the application. I mean, you can actually create nodemon.json and you can do this. Now we were talking about configurations and all, like we need to define the port and all. So what we can do is we can use a .env module for it, which is very important. .env module will help us to expose the configuration. We just need to have a .env file, and we also can include the dependency for this, okay. And we can have a .env file where we can define the server and port. Okay, .env, here we can define our server and port. So both these values will be available in our application to get started. We don't need to hard code it and all. So now our server will look different. Let's change the code to use some TypeScript features. Okay, we are not using Vue.engine, so we'll replace it. Response.json. Okay, and we are listening to this port. Okay. I think build will complain for this. Let's see. .env.config. So this will initialize it. It will read a .env file and put all these variables, server port, MongoDB URL, all these things inside a process variable so that we can access it using process.env. variable name. Now we can do npm run build. Again, all look fine. We have a .env, we have express. Build is done, right? Now this is a basic express application we can create using TypeScript. Now you can follow the same MVC pattern where what you will be doing is you will be creating your controller, services, routes, extend this express example, include the middleware, add the security, add the error handlers for the middlewares like handling the internal server error, or write a common middleware. You can extend this example now to a different level, but this is like how you create a basic setup. Now you can have a proper folder structure here, which will take care of all the definitions of services, controllers, routes, middlewares, all these structures you can create even module wise. I mean, you should always follow a proper folder structure. If I talk about this example, where this is a Nest.js folder structure, app controllers, auth is a separate module, config is a separate module, Redis is a separate module, Swagger is a separate module, and all the modules are getting imported here. This code is a little different. Don't compare it with Express. This is a separate framework which is called Nest.js. It has an inbuilt TypeScript support. It is providing you everything. You just write your modules and bootstrap application. Okay. Here we are using purely TypeScript based implementations, and we can get a lot of advantage from it. So what I will do is I will give you the baseline code for Express application and baseline code for Nest.js. Nest.js, you can just go and create a basic Nest.js REST API service using Nest CLI. Okay, for Express, you can pick any Express code you have already built. Just convert that into TypeScript by just introducing tsconfig.json. By adding the compiler definition for Node and Express, create your tslint so you can take care of the linting of the task. And either you can run this on the fly using tsNode, or just first build it and then start the server from the dist folder. Okay. So this is all we have for this video. In the next video, we'll talk about the comparison of Express with TypeScript and Nest.js. These are two variants, but what you can do is, if you don't want to use a framework, then there are other options also you have. What you can do is you can use a TypeDI or Inversify to add the dependency injection feature with the TypeScript code which you are writing with the Express.js framework, and you can have the same kind of advantage of dependency injection in your Express.js code also with TypeScript. Okay, that's it. Thanks everyone.